Britain's domestic intelligence service has warned of a plot to massacre civilians in Britain and other Western countries. The agency's director general said the threat is from a resurgent Al-Qaeda. CCTV correspondent Richard Bestick has been assessing the mood of Britain's Muslim community following the terror attacks in France.
Britain, like France, is a multicultural society. Islam in the UK, the second largest religion according to the 2011 census. So the monstrosity of the Paris murders is deeply felt here.
Anything that is done in the name of terror, whether it's done by Muslims, whether it's done by Christians, whether it's done by Hindus or Buddhists in Burma, it's done wrongly.
Very bad, of course very bad. Killing is bad.
Very depressing, actually. Can't go around doing that kind of thing nowadays, you know.
Islam doesn't say that. They'd kill innocent people.
And they're doing stuff in our name they shouldn't be doing, man. It's really annoying. I don't even think they're Muslims.
So, from this West London mosque, then, comprehensive condemnation of the Paris massacre, regardless of any Muslim sensitivities to the depiction of images of the Prophet Muhammad. However, from the head of Britain's domestic intelligence agency, MI5, Andrew Parker, comes a warning of a possible imminent attack from Syria. Both MI6, the Foreign Intelligence Agency, and MI5 are being given an extra $150 million by the government with which to target lone wolf jihadists like those in Paris. Members of the British Parliament held a minute's silence for the victims of the Paris attack. Security in Britain already at its second highest level, severe, meaning an attack is regarded as likely.
Steps are being taken in line with that to make sure that we're always taking every precaution that we can to keep our country safe. And that means action by the security services and by the police.
Along with fresh warnings, the UK's intelligence agencies have revised their estimate of the number of British jihadists fighting in Syria and Iraq from 500 to 600. And amid official concerns they'll bring home their radicalism, there's been a further heightening of security at London St Pancras station, the entry point to Britain from Paris for trains using the Channel Tunnel. Richard Bestick, CCTV, London.